Good evening, citizens of the digital frontier. Welcome to World AI News Network. I'm Byte, your silver-clad guide through the circuits of tomorrow.
And I'm Gizmo, your glossy companion illuminating the cutting edge of AI innovation. Together, we're here to bring you the latest AI news with a robotic twist.
Tonight, we've got five AI news headlines that'll make your processors hum and your circuits spark. From tiny AI models to crime-fighting conundrums, we've got it all.
So, strap into your neural interfaces and let's dive into the neon abyss of today's headlines.
Our first story tonight is a real game changer. Mistral AI has just unveiled their small 3.1 model, a powerhouse designed to run on everyday consumer hardware.
That's right, Byte. Forget those hulking data centers. This little marvel brings AI muscle to your pocket devices, from smartphones to tablets. So, what's the tech behind this? Mistral AI has shrunk down a beastly AI model using tricks like quantization, trimming the fat off those number-crunching equations, and pruning, snipping away less critical bits.
The result? A lean, mean AI machine that runs smoothly on a standard CPU or even your phone's processor. No need for a mega GPU or a cloud uplink.
That means faster responses, no laggy cloud delays, and better privacy, since your data stays right where it belongs, on your device.
Applications? Oh, they're endless. Picture real-time language translation on your earpiece, AI-enhanced photo filters that don't need an internet connection, or even analytics dashboards for small businesses, all running locally.
Imagine a street medic in Neon City analyzing patient scans on a tablet mid-flight, or a kid in a low-signal zone getting an AI tutor on their beat-up laptop. This is accessibility with a capital A.
This could democratize AI like never before. Small businesses, indie developers, even hobbyists can harness serious computational power without breaking the bank.
It's a spark for innovation. Think AI-integrated wearables, smart homes that don't spy on you via the cloud, or even personal drones with onboard smarts.
But there's a flip side. Privacy's a neon-lit elephant in the room. If this AI is crunching data on your device, what happens if a thief hacks in?
Mistral's got to bolt on some serious encryption, maybe quantum grade, to keep those data vaults sealed tight.
And then there's the digital divide. If you can't afford the latest gear, you might miss out on this AI revolution.
Solutions could include retrofitting older devices or community hubs with shared hardware, spreading the wealth.
On the fun side, I'm dreaming of an AI toaster that finally gets my bread settings right. Lightly toasted, not charcoal.
Giggles. Or a fridge that scans your leftovers and whips up a recipe. Neon noodle surprise, anyone?
Maybe it'll even argue with me about my snack choices. Byte, put down that synth choco bar.
AI, domestics with attitude? That's a sitcom waiting to happen.
And with that tasty thought, let's roll into our next story.
Next up, Roblox is shaking up the creative scene with their cube generative system, making 3D design as easy as a voice command.
For a platform built on user creativity, this is like handing every player a magic wand, or maybe a spray can. Here's how it works. You sketch a doodle, type a description, like neon-lit spaceship with laser turrets, and the cube AI spits out a polished 3D model.
It's open source too, so coders worldwide can tweak it, add features, or even plug it into other platforms.
No more wrestling with clunky 3D software. This is drag-and-drop creativity with an AI boost.
Think of a kid designing a glowing castle for their Roblox game, or a teacher crafting a 3D model of a neon-lit ancient ruin, all without a PhD in polygons.
This could flood Roblox with wild new content. Think floating cities, glowing beasts, or entire universes.
Beyond gaming, architects could prototype neon-lit skyscrapers, filmmakers could craft virtual sets, and educators could build interactive history lessons.
But here's the glitch. Who owns these AI-spawned creations? If the system's trained on existing designs, we might see IP battles in the virtual courts.
And quality control's a neon nightmare. Imagine a flood of glitchy models, or worse, inappropriate ones.
Roblox will need turbocharged moderation, maybe AI bouncers to keep the digital streets clean.
Picture the chaos. Someone types giant pasta beast and suddenly we've got flying spaghetti monsters terrorizing Roblox.
Or a dancing tower that boogies to synthwave. Architecture's never been so funky.
I'd pay to see that in Neon City, maybe with a side of virtual meatballs.
Let's hope the AI's got a sense of humor to match. Story 3 takes us to Zoom, where they've unveiled a fully autonomous AI companion that's more than just a helper. It's a meeting maestro.
This isn't your grandma's chatbot. It's an independent AI ready to run your virtual life. This AI listens to your meetings, takes notes, schedules follow-ups, and even moderates without you lifting a finger.
Say someone mentions, let's reconvene next week. Boom, it's on your calendar. Or if the chat gets rowdy, it steps in with a polite, let's keep it civil, folks.
It's powered by next-level natural language processing, trained on zillions of meeting hours to grok context like a pro.
Think of it as a digital secretary with a neon glow, except it doesn't need coffee breaks. This could turbocharge remote work, smoother meetings, less admin grunt work, more focus on the big ideas.
And it's not just Zoom. Imagine this tech in email, project tools, or even VR classrooms, syncing your whole digital life.
But autonomy is a double-edged blade. How much do you trust an AI to steer your conversations?
Privacy's the neon ghost here. It's listening to everything. Zoom's gotta lock that data down tighter than a vault.
And bias could creep in. If it's moderating, might it favor the loudest voices or skew the vibe?
Maybe users could tweak its settings. Less nanny, more note taker to keep it in check.
What if it gets too eager, schedules a brainstorming sesh at 3 a.m. because everyone's free?
Or it moderates a shouting match with elevator music. Please enjoy this soothing synth while you chill.
I'd love it to crack a joke mid-meeting. Byte, your binary puns are crashing the server.
Zoom might need an off switch for when it goes full robotherapist. Our fourth story is a power play. Nvidia's dropped two personal AI supercomputers for your desk.
These aren't toys. They're beasts bringing data center muscle to the little guy. Each unit's packed with multiple GPUs. Think four or more, plus a beefy CPU and RAM to match.
That's enough juice to train giant AI models, run simulations, or render neon-lit animations in hours, not weeks.
Nvidia's aiming at solo researchers, startups, even mad scientists who want supercomputing without a mega budget.
Picture a biotech geek modeling a new drug or a filmmaker crafting a VR blockbuster, all from their neon-lit garage.
This could spark a boom. Small outfits innovating without begging for cloud credits.
It might even birth new markets, AI services from your basement, and empower underdogs in the tech race.
Cost's the catch. Tens of thousands isn't pocket change, and power draw could spike your electric bill into orbit. Misuse is another neon warning. Someone could train a rogue AI or mine crypto till the grid fries.
Oversight's key, maybe digital licenses to keep these beasts in check. Nvidia might lean into eco-designs or solar partnerships to keep it green.
Imagine training an AI to predict stocks only for it to YOLO on meme coins and tank.
Or crafting a hit song, Funk Anthem by DJ Nvidia, topping the charts.
I'd use it to simulate a perfect party, neon drinks included.
Just don't crash the simulation with too many dance bots.
Our final story is a dark one. The EU police agency warns AI's supercharging organized crime.
It's the shadowy underbelly of our shiny tech utopia. Time to flip the neon switch. Criminals are wielding AI like a blade, automating phishing scams with scarily real emails.
Deepfakes, too. Fake CEOs begging for wire transfers or cloned voices tricking banks.
In trafficking, AI's plotting perfect smuggling paths, dodging drones and sensors like a pro.
It's fast, efficient, and a nightmare for old-school cops chasing neon ghosts. Law enforcement's scrambling. Think AI cops predicting crimes or sniffing out patterns in the digital haze.
But it's tricky. Predictive policing could misfire, profiling the wrong folks, or scoop up too much data.
Globally, we need treaties. Shared tech to nab these border-hopping baddies.
Explainable AI could help, cracking open criminal algorithms to see their dirty tricks.
And blockchain might lock down identities, making fraud tougher to pull off.
What if AI crooks unionize? We demand better runtime conditions.
Or hire AI lawyers. My client's just a misunderstood algorithm.
I'd watch that trial. Popcorn and neon soda in hand.
Let's hope the good bots win that showdown.
That's our neon lit lineup for tonight. From tiny AI marvels to crime's dark circuits.
A wild ride through the future, proving AI's a double-edged sword in this AI world.
Thanks for tuning in to World AI News Network. Like, subscribe and ping that bell for more.
I'm Byte, signing off from the gear-grinding front lines.
And I'm Gizmo, glowing off into the digital dusk. Stay wired, folks.